The El Segundo blue butterfly is listed as an endangered species, and it had only been known ever from the El Segundo dunes, which go from Bayona Creek down to the Palos Verdes Peninsula. And it was entered onto the endangered species list quite early in the 1970s because its distribution had been limited to really the dunes at Los Angeles International Airport, a little site at the Chevron refinery in El Segundo, and a not very well known, very small site down near the Palos Verdes Peninsula at the southern end of the Santa Monica Bay. And because of that, the limited range and the urbanization had basically taken care of the rest of the range. It was on the endangered species list. And so our project, it's a butterfly that feeds on a single plant, the coast buckwheat or the sea cliff buckwheat, and requires that plant for its whole life cycle. The adults nectar on it, the larvae eat the flower heads, the pupae are formed underneath the plant. It's really tied to this one species of plant. And so with the plant gone and replaced largely by ice plant, which is an import from South Africa, the habitat for the butterfly was gone. I kind of had this aha moment going down to inspect some sites at Malaga Cove, which is where that other relictual native site was. And I parked there at the beach and I looked north and it was just all this ice plant. And I thought, geez, if we could just take that out and put back the native plants, this butterfly would be doing great. With any species, if you've got it limited to only three locations, it's in a bit of peril. And so our project involved putting back the native dune and bluff vegetation, including that food plant for the butterfly, at a couple of sites in Torrance and Redondo Beach. We had two sites, one in Torrance, which was directly a project for the Los Angeles County Department of Beaches and Harbors, and the other, which was funded by state grant money in Redondo Beach, which was somewhat larger. And we did not expect when we did this that the butterfly would get there. The research on the butterfly suggested that it moved very short distances, that it was very closely tied to its food plant, and that if it was going to make it to these new habitats, we'd probably have to help it along. And this was based on the published literature that was out there and people's experience with the species. However, now, I guess, 3-4 years later for the two sites, the butterfly shows up, making me look a little silly, surprising me and others who didn't think that it would happen on its own. And so that's been a great reward of the project. And this is one of the instances where it's the sort of bluff of dreams. If you build it, they will come. And in this instance, they came, which was a really great surprise. The population that's now established at Torrance and Redondo Beach seems to be relatively dense. We saw a couple hundred butterflies over this 4-acre area in a day, and it's probably then more butterflies there than are actually present on that native site that was there previously to the south from where the colonists came, so to speak. This is great progress along the road to potentially downlisting the species. There's a recovery plan in place that requires the establishment of a series of protected populations in different parts of the historic range of the species in order for the classification to be changed from endangered to threatened. And if this progress continues and other areas are likewise restored, and there are projects in the works in Manhattan Beach, Dockweiler, other areas up and down the Santa Monica Bay. If these areas are restored, the butterflies return, and they're stable and are protected, then the Fish and Wildlife Service, the federal agency that's responsible for the maintenance of the Endangered Species Act and its implementation, can consider changing the classification, just as what recently happened with the bald eagle.